Hi, and welcome to this review of Mechanical Advantage. In this review, we'll take a look at the formula for mechanical advantage, go over how this principle is related to work and energy, and review a few real-life situations where this principle could be used. Let's get started. Mechanical advantage comes into play when you use something like a ramp, a pulley, or a lever to make moving things easier. We'll dive into these examples in a minute, but before we do, here are a few formulas to be familiar with. First is the conservation of energy, which is initial energy equals final energy. Second is a different version of the conservation of energy, work input equals work output. And third is the mechanical advantage formula, which is MA equals the output force over the input force, which equals the input distance over the output distance. Now, let's look at our first example. For this example, imagine you're trying to get a piano onto the stage of an auditorium. You look at the steps and immediately think, well, that isn't going to happen. So you go down to the lumberyard and grab some wood so you can make a ramp. When you set it up and try to push the piano up onto the stage, you realize you're still not strong enough. That is, you can't provide enough force by yourself to get it up the ramp. So you go back to buy some more wood to make your ramp twice as long as it was originally. You put the ramp in place and find that you can now push the piano up the ramp by yourself. You've gained the mechanical advantage to overcome the force of gravity. Let's check out what's going on behind the scenes to make this happen. You're applying a force to move the piano some distance. Meanwhile, gravity is pulling down over this distance, h, while you move the piano up the ramp. You may already be aware that the definition of work is equal to the force applied over the distance moved. So while you're doing some work to push the piano up the ramp, gravity is doing some work trying to pull the piano down. Now, remember, the work that you do is equal to the work that gravity is doing. In the most general sense, the work you put into moving the piano results in changing the height of the piano, which is called the work output. Also, keep in mind that this equation is a version of the conservation of energy, which basically says that what you start with is what you end with. In other words, the initial energy of a system, in this case, the work you put in, is equal to the final energy of the system, the work gravity does pulling down over the distance h. This is because work equals force times distance. Otherwise stated, the force you push with over the distance d is equal to the force that gravity pulls with over the distance h. Now that we've gotten the basic idea that work in equals work out, let's take a look at a simple lever system to derive the mechanical advantage equation. Here, we have a seesaw with a child sitting on one end and you standing by the other end. Let's say you push down on your end of the seesaw. Since your force down times the distance you push is equal to the force of gravity times the change in height of the child, we can rearrange this equation by getting the forces on one side and the heights on the other. Then we get Fp over Fg equals Hg over Hp. Each of these is a way to express mechanical advantage. Now, take a look at these triangles. Since these are both similar triangles, the mechanical advantage equation can also be written as dg over dp. Notice that by decreasing the distance you push, you can increase the amount of force you need to push with, and you lose a mechanical advantage. Let's go back to our piano and ramp example. This time, you have two ramps, one that is 2 meters and one that is 4 meters. Let's figure out what force you would have to push with to get the piano up each ramp. Since we already have our equation for mechanical advantage, we can solve it, as before, for the force in. If the weight of the piano is 2,500 newtons, the height of the stage is 1 meter, the length of ramp 1 is 2 meters, and the length of the second ramp is 4 meters, we can see that the amount of force needed for the longer ramp is half of the amount, which would provide a mechanical advantage. Let's take a look at another type of lever system, a wrench. This particular wrench is designed to make opening jars easier for people. Here's how it works. You grab your wrench, fasten it to the lid, and boom, the lid comes off with no trouble. Let's check out what's really going on here. Imagine your hand has 2 points of contact on the lid. You try twisting from the wrist, but nothing is happening. Notice the distance between your wrist and the lid is pretty short. Then you put the wrench on the lid at the same contact points, noticing that you're applying the force at a greater distance. Because of this, you can do more work on the lid, so the lid spins with no problem. Now, let's take a look at a couple of rope and pulley systems to see how such a setup can make lifting an object easier. Let's say, for this final example, that a statue was taken down for a restoration project, and you got the job to place it back up on the podium. You attach a rope to the sculpture, loop it over the pulley fixed to the roof, and begin to pull. If the statue weighs 60,000 newtons, you will have to pull with a force greater than 60,000 newtons to lift the statue. Notice that the tension in the rope is the same on both sides of the pulley, yet there's only one rope pulling the statue up. What if you lifted the sculpture with a block and tackle system? Remember that the tension in the rope is the same at all points. As you can see, when you pull with one T, the statue is now lifted by the equivalent of four ropes, each of which has a tension T. So your one T gets converted into four T, and you gain the mechanical advantage once again over the force of gravity. However, this advantage comes at a cost, as it always does. The distance you must pull the rope is four times greater than it would be with a single pulley. And there you have it. By using things like levers, pulleys, and ramps, you can amplify your input force by increasing the distance you are from an object. Now, before we go, let's test your knowledge with a few review questions. Number one, what is the definition of mechanical advantage? A, getting something moving from rest. B, using a ramp to roll something down. C, amplifying an input force by some mechanical means. Or D, turning Newton's first law into the second law. The answer is C. If you look at F in equals F out times D out over DN, you can see that since D out over DN by design is less than 1, you're cutting down the input force or amplifying the output force. Number two, the work in equals the work out formula is based on which basic concept of physics? A, conservation of mass. B, Newton's law of universal gravitation. C, Newton's third law of equals and opposites. D, conservation of energy. The correct answer is D. If the energy of a system doesn't change, then the work in is equal to the work out. Number three, the relationship between force and distance is A, direct, B, inverse, C, linear, or D, radical. The correct answer is B. Looking at Fn equals F out times D out over Dn, it is easily seen that as D out increases, F out decreases. That's all for this review. Thanks for watching and happy studying.